Megan Taylor work with corrections today. So let's take a look at this problem. It says, a recipe for a tray of granola bars calls for 2/3 cup of chopped almonds. And corrections always make me hungry. Megan was making 5 batches of the granola bars. How many cups of chopped almonds does she need? Show a visual representation and write an equation to solve this problem. So, after reading this and thinking, I know that she needs 2/3 a cup of almonds for one batch, but she needs to make 5. So I think what we need to do is multiply 5 times 2/3. We're going to take a look at a quick visual representation. You can sketch one. I'm going to just show you one that I made on the computer just because it's a little bit easier for me to take a look at making sense of this column. Okay, so here we have our model. And what I did was I drew 5 circles to represent the 5 batches, and I broke those into thirds to show 2/3 for each batch. So we have 2/3 5 times to show 5 times 2/3. So I know that if I multiply a whole number by a fraction, I can multiply the whole number by the numerator. Oops, let's get a pen here. By the numerator, which is 10, and my pieces are going to stay thirds, right? So I get 10/3. But I want to write this as a mixed number. 10/3 is, doesn't really make sense. It doesn't make sense of the problem if I say 10/3 cups. I can answer that in a mixed number to be a little bit more clear and specific. So what is 10/3 as a mixed number? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to color in blue thirds using the same diagram. I know that 3/3 equals 1 whole, right? So I have 10/3. So this is 1, 2, 3. I'm going to keep track. That's 1 whole over here. So I'm just going to layer it on top. 4, 5, 6. That's 2 wholes. 7, 8, 9. That's 3 wholes. And then I have 10 because I had 10 1/3 pieces. So I have 3 holes and 1/3 as shown by the blue color in the picture here. What else? I couldn't try to make my 3 by this. Another thing that I could have done is I could have thought, well, 3/3 is 1 hole. So 3/3, I'm having trouble making 3s today. 3/3 plus 3/3. That gives me 6/3 plus 3/3 to get 9/3, right? So that's my 3 wholes, and I could even say, okay, that's 9/3. Write it down here. 9/3. And I know that 1 more 1/3 would be 1 left over, so that would be 3 wholes, because I have 1 hole, 2 wholes, 3 wholes, 3 wholes, and 1/3. Okay, so 10/3 is equivalent to 3 1/3 as a mixed number. Well, Meadow's not done with her granola bars because she still needs the oats. So in the same recipe, you need 2 2/3 cups of oats. That's for one batch. How many cups of oats does Meadow need for the 5 batches of granola bars? So just like before, I think I'm visualizing our equation as 5 because that's the number of batches we're making, times 2 2/3 cups of oats. Now this is new because we haven't multiplied a whole number by a mixed number yet. So we're going to explore some different strategies for that. I'm going to draw a model. So here I have the model, and what I did was I drew out 2 2/3, and then I just did it 5 times for each batch. So here is 1 hole, 2 holes, 2/3. 1 hole, 2 holes, 2/3. So each line represents one of the batches of cookies. Okay. So I see some holes here. I can just count those. So I can think of it as 5 times 2 equals 10. And the reason I'm doing 5 times 2 is, I'm just going to put a check mark and I'm knowing that's what I'm talking about here, is because those are 2 holes. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8. Oops, 6, 8, 10. I counted wrong. Let's do that again. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So 5 times 2. So I know that I have 10 whole cups of oats needed. But then here, I still have these additional pieces that I need to add in. So I know that that's 2/3 five times. So I did 5 times 2 for my whole, right? But now I'm gonna do 5 times 2/3. This may look familiar because we're actually using the distributive property. We're doing 5 times 2 plus 5 times 2/3. Well, using the same strategy we've been working on the last couple lessons, 5 times 2/3 is 10/3. So, I know that I'm not done though. I need to add these together, just as we do when we use the distributive property. So I know that my answer is 10 plus 10/3, but that doesn't really make sense, right? I'm not making sense of the problem. Somebody said, how many cups of oats do we need to make this recipe? And I said, 10 plus 10/3. It'd be very confusing. So I'm going to take these numbers, a whole number and a fraction greater than one, and I'm going to combine them and rename them as a mixed number, as one single mixed number. So what is 10/3 as a mixed number? Well, just like we did in our last lesson, I can figure that out. This time I'm actually going to use division. I'm going to change colors so it's a little bit easier to follow. So I know that I can do 10 divided by 3 because there are 3 parts, 3/3 make one whole. So I know that 10 divided by 3. Well, let's think about this. Ooh, 3 times 3 is 9. So I'm really struggling here. Hold on. Here we go. It's a race. No, I'm not erasing. Okay. I'm not sure why my eraser isn't working. Maybe if I do this. There we go. Okay. Sorry about that. So I know that 3 times 3 is 9. So what I need to do is 3 times 3 is 9, which means I have one left over or one remaining. Well, that one isn't one. It's really 1/3 piece. So I can write it like this. Okay, so now what? Now I know that I have 10 plus 3 1/3. That's much easier for me to work with. So I'm going to write down here, I'm running out of space, 10 plus 3 1/3. Well, 10 plus 3, I'm going to use my whole numbers first. 10 plus 3 is 13 and 1/3 cups. So I know that Meadow needs 10 and 1/3 cups of oats to make 5 batches of granola bars. So to recap this problem, because we did quite a bit on this, when you're multiplying a whole number by a mixed number, it really makes a lot of sense to use the distributive property and break your mixed number into a whole number and into a fraction. So we did our whole numbers multiplied together first, right? So 5 times 2 equals 10. And then we took our whole number and multiplied it by our fraction, 5 times 2/3, to get 10/3. And then we're left with a fraction greater than 1, which we know how to turn into a mixed number. We can then add our two products together, right, to get our final product.